Now let us join our palms and together we are requesting His Holiness, our lineage Guru, the Grand Master Lu, Living Buddha Lien Shin, to bestow Dharma teaching. First homage to the lineage gurus, the Venerable Mang Liaoming, Master Sakya Zhenkong, the 16th Dharma King Karmapa, and Master Thubten Daji. Homage to the main deity, to the three jewels represented on the altar. Simu, all Dharma masters, Dharma educators, Dharma teachers, Dharma lecturers, Dharma teaching assistants, leaders of temples and chapters, all Dharma followers present and over the webcast, and our honorable guest.
My older sister, Lu Shengmei. My second sister, Lu Yiyi, and Asim.
From Hong Kong Chinese University, Professor Tan. From Kaohsiung Navy College, Professor Chen. From the Taichung City Council, Ms. Wu. From the Nantou City Council, Mrs. Xu, Mr. Xu. And the representative for the Speaker of Democratic Progressive Party, Mr. Huang. And from the Woodcutting Charity from Taichung, Ms. Chen, and from Academia Sinica, Professor and Mrs. Chu. From the town of Cao Tun's candidate, Mr. Lai. From the Cao Tun town, the Sanjiao neighborhood, the head of the neighborhood, Mr. Chen. Everyone, good afternoon. How do you do? First, I would like to make an announcement on some personnel issues. It's not a command, it's just an announcement. In the past, I have said that if you have built a Lijiang temple, and if you're a member of the Sangha, an ordained monk or nun, and you give a lot of efforts in Dharma propagation, and you have a strong commitment to spiritual cultivation, and after you complete the building of the Lijiang Temple, and I have said that I would confer Vajra Acharya empowerment. And there are two people from Fa Yin Leizang Temple and Fa Sen Leizang Temple. Fa Sen, Fa Yin Leizang Temple is Master Lian Hai, and Reverend Lian Shi built the Fa Sen Leizang Temple. So it's Reverend Lian Shi here. So from now on, you should learn the purity of the Ma Junli and her 18 hands. You use them to help sentient beings and persevere in your spiritual cultivation. So from now on, I would confer the Vajra Acharya empowerment. The master empowerment. So, Vajra Master Si Lian Shi. And the Zhun Ping chapter from Malaysia, Dharma Sister Lian Hua Jia Xing, she would be appointed as a Dharma educator. Or the senior Dharma assistant. And from the Putong Yuan, Li Fuhua is also appointed as the Dharma educator, Dharma instructor, which is the one with the blue color. Xu Guo Sheng is also appointed as the Dharma instructor. So I personally, it is my opinion that as a Dharma propagator, the first condition for a Dharma propagator is that you have to have a strong commitment to spiritual cultivation. And the second principle is that you have to be diligent in practicing the Tripada Tantric Dharma and in leading other people to practice it. And moreover, you want to widely deliver sentient beings to be self-enlightened and to enlighten others and to have the four immeasurables, to have compassion, mercy, loving-kindness, joy, and equanimity. So the foremost condition for a Dharma propagator is you have to have a strong commitment and never waver from spiritual cultivation. And you need to be very diligent in your own practice. So if you don't deliver other sentient beings, then what Dharma propagation are you doing? Or if you don't get self-enlightened or enlighten others, then what kind of Dharma propagation are you doing? This is very important. And from Seattle, Master Lian Ning, Reverend Lian Yo, right?
Lian Yo Fa-si.
When I was at the Tripada Foundation office, I have observed her for a long time. She should have met the requirements for a master. And at the same time, she's also a green Padma Kumara. So from Seattle Lizhang Temple, Reverend Lian
Yiu,
from this moment on, she's also conferred the empowerment for a Vajra Acharya master. So, from now on, all Dharma propagators should comply to the principles I just mentioned above. So, if you don't have a strong commitment in on your spiritual cultivation, how could you do Dharma propagation? If you yourself are not pure, or if you're not enlightened, how could you do the Dharma propagation? And if you don't rightly deliver sentient beings, how could you do the Dharma propagation? So please remember these statements. So our True Buddha school is not earning a living, but we are fighting for the deliverance of all sentient beings. The Dharma propagators should not just earning a living. That, you know, all True Buddha disciples are not becoming rich, but only the Dharma propagators becoming rich. That's not right. But, you know, we are striving to deliver a sentient being, not striving to earn the money, to earn a living. So today we had Mahajundi, Buddha Mother Homa, and she's the personal deity or yidam of Grand Master's Guru, Master Pu Fang. When he spoke in Taiwanese to me, so the first statement would be the foremost place of refuge. So from this statement, the Mahajundi would appear. So her Dharma power, the purity power, and the deliverance power are incredible. According to what I know, that Mahajundi is also the personal deity of the Jina, the Jina religious sect of India. And she's also the personal deity of Master Pu Fang. And she's one of the True Buddha school's eight primary deities. She's very precious. Not only that she can open the divine eye. Just now, when I was in meditation, that my fingers move upward automatically, and then touch my divine eye, and then my left eye, and then my right eye. And when the finger touched the brow point, the divine eye, the wisdom light was emitted. When I touched my right eye, Grandmaster saw the great radiance of the sun. And when I touched my left eye, I saw the great radiance of the moon.